Today I'm going to be showing you how to get your Tiny Media Manager info files to pull into Plex. Because we all know we take a lot of time creating our perfect library, and Plex does not scrape or pull in that information. It uses its own scrapers no matter what we do. A little frustrating, especially when we're picking out, you know, the perfect info file with the perfect description and all that stuff. Some of the scrapers on Plex may just give one sentence for a description of a show, but we're going out finding all of the correct images and, you know, correct ratings, all that stuff. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start off in Tiny Media Manager. I currently am running V4. This works on V3 and every other edition. But I was recently given a key by someone very nice for a year trial to kind of do some videos on V4. Now, I will not really be covering too much of V4 today, as this is more focused on getting our info files imported to Plex. So I'm going to start bare bones. I'm going to remove my TV shows, just starting from the beginning here. So if we take a look at my videos here, I've got two folders named TV shows that I will be showing you as a comparison. This one will be imported using Plex's normal scraper, and this one will be using the XBMC info importer. So that'll be this directory, and as you can see, it's really just the video files right now. So I'm going to go ahead and update my sources. Did I not add it? I did not add it. Okay, so I want to add my data source first. I want to add TV shows, and then I want to add the other one, TV shows with the info. So now I'm going to hit close, update my sources. Both should populate, and as you can see here, we're missing just about everything, which is pretty standard when you import something. So what we're going to do is hold down control, click both of these. We're going to search and scrape and make sure this is the correct year and the correct thing. So I'm going to hit OK, that's correct. OK, that is correct. And we're going to let it do its thing here. Pulling information, getting the media info, downloading the images, syncing with my Track TV accounts, etc. So if I click these drop downs, we can see things are starting to populate here. Okay. So it's loading. And as you can see, this star icon is the ratings. And it doesn't seem to be pulling in the ratings, but there's this great feature in V4 where you can actually specifically just look for ratings. So if I click on both of these, right click, I go down to Enhanced Editing, and I go Fetch Ratings for Selected TV Shows / Episodes. I'm going to click this drop down, select all because I want all of these ratings. Okay. And now you can see our ratings have just populated. So now if I open everything up, you can see we got ratings for each show. Same with upload. And if I look in these folders now you see we have an info file for every single every single episode, as well as the TV show itself. So I open them in Notepad here. You can see that's going to be our plot right there. So this is, which one will this be? This will be the one that Plex will be scraping. Okay, so I'm going to leave that alone. And just to prove that this is importing, I'm going to edit one of these info files, just so you guys can see that it truly is importing this. So I'm gonna put After Earth, screw Plex for not having this as default. Okay, save. So that's my info file for season 1, episode 1. So that's pretty much it for Tiny Media Manager, except for rename and clean up. Let that rename, clean up everything. Everything is pretty much already set, but it is necessary if the folder structure is not complete, or you just kind of have video files laying around. It's going to put them in their season folders and put them in, rename the episode show folder. The cool thing about V4 is it also automatically downloads the theme music. Very cool. So, once this is complete, we can pretty much close out of Tiny Media Manager. I'll let this run for just a second. Okay, it is set. All done. Next, what you're going to want to do, open up your internet browser. Let's see which tab. And we're going to go to Google. And we're going to type in web tools. You can manually install the XBMC Movie Importer, but this is much simpler. So Web Tools Bundle Plex, very first link. We're going to click on Wiki, and then Installing Web Tools. Download Web Tools here. Click on our Web Tools Bundle.zip. Save it wherever you would like. I'm going to pop it on my desktop. Minimize. And it went right here. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and extract this right here. And there it is. Okay. So that's our Web Tools Bundle folder. Alright, so I want to make sure it's not double named. You can see it's webtools.bundle and then inside webtools.bundle. We don't want that. So I'm going to move it here. And now it pulls out correct. Okay, so now we need to put this folder into our plugins directory. So we're going to hit Windows key R and we are going to press local app data percent. Oops. Plex media server plugins. Ooh. Plugins. And then hit OK. And now you can see where we are in our Plex media server plugins folder. So all you have to do, drag and drop. That's it for that. Close it out. Exit Plex Media Server. Reopen it. Double click it. And now we are at our home page here. So currently, this is a fresh install as everything is already set up on my main Plex server, so I did not want to kind of uninstall everything and run back through it. So right now, I have nothing in my libraries or anything like that. But if I go to my plugins, now we see our Web Tools plugin. So take notes or copy this port number right here. And you are going to navigate, if you are on your Plex server, you're going to navigate to HTTP localhost along with the port number at the end there. If you are not on your Plex media server, but would still like to do this, type in the IP address of the Plex server along with the port number at the end. And what we're going to load into is the Web Tools area. And it's going to ask for your Plex user credentials. This is a new one. What do I have as my name? That's IR64. And your Plex password. These are your login credentials for Plex. And then once we have logged into Web Tools, we're going to hit this UAS, which stands for Unsupported App Store. And on this area over here in search, we're going to type in hit all first, and then X, B, and C. And as you can see, I do already have them installed. And once the install button will be right here. You're going to install both of these, once for movies, once for their TV shows, and after you hit install, hit update as well. And I'm going to double check our AppDater plugin folder, and now we see they're both installed. Much easier than doing it manually. So now we can go back to Plex, and the first thing we want to do actually is exit it again. So we want to restart it. And then Plex, okay. Start it back up. Give it a refresh here. Now I go back to my settings, scroll down, go to my agents tab. And now you can see we have this for a new scraper in Plex. XBMC Movies Importer, because we're on the movie section. It's checked by default. What I personally like to do is I like to use the Plex Movie Legacy and make sure the Movies Importer is all the way at the top, just in case it doesn't pull all. Maybe we didn't get some fields in Tiny Media Manager and it just wasn't possible to get all the fields. I like to have some backups, but just in case. For this, we're not really focusing on movies, we're focusing on shows. So for here, we're going to use XBMC Info Importer. So that's all set up. Don't really have to do much about it right now. So I don't have any libraries added. And if you do, the unfortunate thing is if you want it to pull all of the info files for that library, you're unfortunately going to have to delete it first and re-add it. Kind of a drawback, but you do it once, then you don't have to worry about it. So TV shows. This is going to be TV shows info, because I'm going to show you what it looks like when I import with the infos. So let me see, TV shows info, add, go to advanced, click the agent drop down, XBMC info importer. And now we see there's some options here you can kind of run through. Agents, artwork location, local, meaning all of those images that Plex has downloaded, or I mean Tiny Media Manager has downloaded, will be pulled into Plex now. Very handy, along with the info file. So this is just some brief settings. I pretty much leave everything as default. So I'm gonna hit add library. And I'm going to add the second one, which is the standard Plex scraped one. TV shows, standard, advanced, leave it, add library. This is just to show you. So now if I go back to my home, I've got TV shows info and TV shows. So if I click on TV shows, I've got my one show here, scraped by Plex, and you can see the movie database percentage right there. Here's Plex's scrape description. You got all your cast. Here's all the episodes. So now if I go to my TV shows info, you can see it looks the same right now. And in here, you can see that we've got, this is the full description. So this would be the info file in the root of the TV show. I will show you. So Raised by Wolves, it's this info file that appears right here. So if I hit edit notepad, you can see After Earth, blah, blah, blah. So it's pulling from that. Let's check on our episode 1 info. So if I click on our 1, screw Plex for not having this as default. Boom. In there. So you can see here, though, there's the main drawback is if you would like to edit any of these info files for any of these episodes in here, It doesn't matter what you do, whether you rescan the metadata, whatever, it's not going to pull it. Your only option for media that has already been imported, if you have edited things in the info file, is to completely delete the library and re-add it again, which is kind of a drawback. But any new content that you add, so let me go ahead and show you that. So any new shows that you add, or episodes, movies, whatever it may be, to that folder, it will use that scraper, the XBMC video scraper. So if I cut this, get rid of it, pop it into here. Okay. Windows 11 sometimes confusing. All right. So now it's in there. If I go back to my settings, here I am actually, my libraries, I can delete the regular one now because that's no longer applied. Delete. And then I'm going to scan library files. And the activity, let's see, finish processing upload. So it ran through those, so let's check it out. TBMG. Upload, and as you can see, we've got a different thing here now that's provided by our info file, and now everything has been pulled from the info files, and even the images that are downloaded as the still thumbnails of the TV shows themselves are populated. So if I look at this, that's for season 1, episode 1. Boom, season 1, episode 1. So that's essentially how you import all of your info files and hard work and images that you've done in Tiny Media Manager into Plex itself. There are some drawbacks. You are not going to get any of those extra features anymore. If you have a Plex Pass, you may know that when you click on a show, a lot of the times you'll scroll down here. It'll have trailers. It'll have, you know, extra behind the scenes stuff. It's not going to have any of that anymore. This is really just if you are really focused on having your library set up how you want it completely, then go this method. If you want all the extra bells and whistles, scrape it with the normal Plex scraper. But other than that, you are pretty much all set. There's nothing more to do. Everything will be importing using the Tiny Media Manager data information that we have been working on. So that is my video today. I make a lot of videos relating to Plex and Tiny Media Manager and just overall movie library organization. So if that is your niche or that is something you'll like to learn, please subscribe to my channel and give this video a like if it helped you. And don't forget, I will be posting some new videos soon of Tiny Media Manager V4. It's made some great changes. I do like it. But that is all for today, so you guys have a great night.